Have you ever seen these portable laptop screen extenders advertised? Because I had seen these products that kind of clip onto your laptop and they extend a screen, and I was admittedly skeptical. But then I just had to pick one up. This is the Kwumsy Portable Laptop Screen Extender S1 Slim. It came with this really cool carrying case, in addition to not one, not two, but three USB-C cables. Each USB cable has a different connection. This one is USB-A to C or standard USB to USB-C. Then we have an HDMI, regular HDMI to USB-C. So if you have a device that has an HDMI output, and then we have USB-C to USB-C, and it's a nice little L shape on there. Inside the carrying case, we have the actual screen. It doesn't look like much, but that's okay. In order to open it, you gotta kind of pull it out, and then this extends out. There's this little switch up here at the top that sits on top of the laptop, and then you use that like a clamp. Just make sure you flip that down before you close it. And how you store it is the same thing. Right here is where your connections are. So you have it says Type C1, Type C2, and HDMI. On the top, there is this little dial, I think for volume up and volume down, or you can push it to turn it on or off. On the back here, you have a kickstand, which you can put on the back of your laptop. And then the instructions say you twist, so what you do is you twist it up, and you can pull it down and either lock it in on one side or another there. If your laptop lid couldn't support the weight, you could use that kickstand to take some of the weight. 15-inch laptop here. I did try this on a smaller laptop, and this was a little too big for the smaller laptop. It didn't exactly line up. But for a larger laptop, larger than maybe like a 13-inch screen, this will probably work great. Clamp on the screen, and right there on the top is where that little fold-out sits. And you can see if this is heavy, so if you have it extended out, it will pull your laptop lid back, which is where your kickstand comes into play. And so that's where we can extend this down. Say maybe I want it to sit right there, which is way back, or I can pull it a little further out and have that stand up. And then we got this screen over here. Because this laptop can power this screen, I don't need to use an external power source. If your laptop does not have a USB-C output that can power the screen, you're going to have to use probably the USB-A to USB-C or the USB-C to USB-C or even this HDMI to USB-C. Run the cable into the screen for the display, and then you're going to have to run a separate cable out for the power to the screen. Let's just plug it into the USB-C port on the side, and then on the back of the unit, I'm going to plug it in to the two port, the middle port right there. When I hooked this up, I plugged it into the one port and it didn't do anything. So let's see if the two port works better. I don't see any screen. Let me try to turn it on. There it comes. And there it is. And so you'll see I already have this arranged. So if I drag my mouse over here, it shows up over there. The resolution is way off though, so I'm going to go into my display settings, click on the S1, and I'll see right now it says default is 960 by 540, which is a really, really tiny resolution, or I guess big, depending on your perspective. So everything is going to look really huge. I'm going to put that down to 920 by 1080, which is kind of a standard HD resolution. Now it looks much better. That's all there is to it. So you can see the extended screen real estate. It works very well. I've already used it a couple times. So what I'll do is I'll bring up my Crate Hackers app here and then put it over on the side, which is one of my favorite apps. And I can even full screen this app over here, so I have that for reference. And then I can open up my DJ program. So while I am playing music here, I can go over here and I can look through songs or match tracks or whatever I need to do. So this is useful for a great many use cases. If you're doing live streaming, I was using it on a live stream and I had my live stream feed over here so I could see what was actually happening and I could respond to any comments or anything while over here I had my DJ software running. So it does act exactly like an extended monitor. That's some things to note, some of the things that I like. Now let's talk about some of the things I maybe don't like. Well, first, I would say the instructions were not incredibly clear. When I plugged in this display for the first time, I put it in USB-C 1 and I got nothing from the display whatsoever. I tried different USB ports and it wasn't working. It should work on all the USB ports, but when I first did display 1, it just gave me a black screen. This looks like it's working now, and it actually pulled in at 1920, so the right resolution. So maybe once you connect it the first time, it's okay. But the initially when I connected it, I turned it on, it was plugged into the C1 port and it didn't work. So if you have that experience, just make sure that you try a different port. One of the other things that I don't really like is just the weight of it. I don't like something this heavy hanging onto my laptop because I don't want to damage the hinge on the laptop. My laptop screen can support it as long as I have the weight well balanced, but I don't know if I would trust this if I wasn't using the kickstand or if it was in a wobbly situation. I wouldn't want this to fall forward or backward because of the weight. Obviously, if this fell forward, I could potentially damage the screen on my laptop, which is a lot more expensive than this screen. Or if this got mistakenly flipped closed, I could crack the screen or damage the screen, which is definitely not something that you want to happen. But overall, I'm very impressed with the way that this works for what it is and at the price point it was at. If you need an extra screen on your laptop, you need some more screen real estate, this is definitely a great option. So that's the Kwumsy Portable Laptop Screen Extender S1 Slim. It does what it says and it will extend your laptop screen, give you a little more real estate, hopefully make you a little more productive. The instructions could be a bit more clear. I plugged in originally to the first USB-C port, my screen did not come on. I plugged it into the second USB port, my screen came on. I don't know if that was just a fluke or that was just me. I just tried it now, plugged it into both USB-C 1 and 2 ports, and it worked just fine. Initially, when you plug this in, the monitor is going to be super low resolution. At least it was for me, so that's something that you're going to have to go in right away. Make sure you update, change the resolution to 1920 by 1080. Unless you want something that's really big, you can keep it at that resolution, but just keep that in mind that by default, at least in my experience, it did not jump to its native 1920 by 1080p resolution. If this was a touchscreen, it would be glorious. That would add so much to the experience if you could actually use this as an extendable touchscreen as well for your computer. Well, I understand why it's not, but that would be awesome if this had some touchscreen features. Another thing that you can do with this device, because it does have the HDMI in from the HDMI out on the switch, and you can run a switch on this just by putting the kickstand. However, I didn't find the experience to be that great, because the kickstand doesn't really hold this thing up very well, so just this as a screen doesn't work probably near as well as it should. You can make it work, but it's kind of flimsy. The other thing is, if you're going to use this with a switch or a phone or something for an external display for something that cannot drive the power to it like the switch, you're going to have to also plug in another USB-C cable to it and plug it into the wall in order to get power to the unit. And it didn't come with a wall adapter for power, so you will have to supply your own. If you're interested in purchasing this for yourself, I do have a link in the description below. Disclaimer, that is an affiliate link, so if you click there and you purchase this, I may get a little bit of a kickback from Amazon, so you're not obligated to do that, but if you do, it supports me, it supports the channel, and I definitely appreciate it. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this.